Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to Chapter House and King's Magnus Speech Day 2019. Before we begin with the official proceedings, there are just a few housekeeping announcements that I need to make you aware of. We're not expecting an alarm today, but in the unlikely event of an alarm sounding, please be aware that there are three exits in the space, one just behind you and two either side of the stage. Please follow the instructions from staff on duty and exit through your nearest door, unless it becomes crowded. You should then assemble on the AstroTurf at the front of the building and wait there until instructed that the alarm is over. Please, could I also ask that you not try to locate your child or children if they are not sitting with you this morning. Staff will ensure that they are evacuated safely and will be taken to a different muster point where a register will be taken. Now, if you have a mobile phone, could I ask that you turn it off or onto silent? Whilst you may wish to take photographs or film your child receiving an award this morning, we would like to remind you that photographs that include other people's children should not be uploaded onto social media without consent being given. Official photographs of prize winners will be taken in the Genesis Library at the end of the ceremony this morning, and these will be available via the QE website from next week. There will be opportunities to take photographs outside after the ceremony. And after the ceremony today, you are warmly invited to enjoy some light refreshments in the marquee that you passed on your way in. And so, to the start of the official proceedings this morning. In a few moments, we will hear Priscilla Ho in Year 9 playing Prelude No. 10 by Debussy. And after that, we will welcome in our stage party with a round of applause. At the end of our final hymn, Shine, Jesus, Shine, we would ask that you remain standing while the stage party and prize winners leave the space. Chapter House students will then be escorted back to school by their teachers and can be collected from the front entrance of Chapter House. King's Magnus students will meet you in the marquee. All that remains for me to say is to wish you a fabulous and enjoyable speech day and a wonderful summer break. Thank you.
Thank you. Can I ask you to please stand for the stage party?
Mrs. Mylene Class, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, mums and dads, staff members, but most importantly, our students. Welcome to our 2019 Speech Day. I don't think that there is anyone in the past few weeks who hasn't referred to how quickly this year has gone. It seems to get quicker each year, and what surprises me is just how much our staff and students manage to fit into one year. And then we have to encapsulate it into an hour and a half today. Tricky. My first thanks of the day go to my school board members, Chris Hall, Jackie Hales, Lawrence McKell, Karen Halsley, and Matthew Adshead. As always, their time and input has been so valuable and welcomed by many, especially myself. A sincere thanks go to Steve Jandrell, Dan Machin, Stephen Turner, and Karen Kilkenny, along with their superb teams of staff, for all their hard work, dedication, and good humour this past year. As most of you know, we have a fantastic team behind the scenes across many departments, including IT, estates, catering, housekeeping, and all of our office staff. So a huge thank you to them for all the work that they do to ensure that we are looked after to an exceptional standard. Today is, of course, about our students. But first, I would like to address our staff and just say a very heartfelt thank you. These are just two small words, but they are hugely important. Our staff work hard. They're committed to delivering the very best. And what I've seen again is just how well our staff know our students and how much they genuinely care for their well-being. They bring a strong sense of rapport, a welcome ear, and most importantly, knowledge and experience. There is not a month that passes by without me delivering a long-term service presentation to a member of our team. It's a great part of my role and one I find an absolute privilege. For every award that I present, I feel a huge sense of pride that I'm the one in the position that gets to thank that staff member and present them with their eagle. This academic year alone, 42 eagles have been presented for 7 years of service, 27 eagles for 10 years of service, and 4 eagles for 15 years. The loyalty, commitment, and dedication that our teams contribute to our students and our collegiate is remarkable. This is shown from those staff members who have yet to receive their first eagle to the one who is on the highest of 34 years of service. One word that I have no doubt that you will hear today many times is inspection. and rightfully so. February gave us the opportunity to show exactly what we are made of. And following a rigorous inspection process, we were awarded the highest grade of ratings of outstanding in our early years and excellent in our four schools. Inspection results are not achieved from 1 week of extra long hours. And making sure that the inspectors have the paperwork, see who they need to see, and read what they need to read. It's the year-round effort, year on year, that builds, that ensured that our exceptional result was achieved and truly deserved. I couldn't have been prouder, and I shouted it from the rooftops, and I quickly corrected those who thought that excellent was not as good as outstanding, and made sure that they knew that those grades were the best that we could get. I was proud of our students. You showed how exactly talented, amazing, and spirited that you are. For our staff, the work that they do was recognised externally and officially, not just known internally. At Year 5's assembly this year, where they recount their year, the students spoke of success and how it made them feel. Kitty had said that when you get successful, you get a buzz of happiness and a sparkle of joy. Monty summed it up by saying, "You know when you've been successful because you can't stop smiling and feeling great." And Dasha told us, "To be successful means different things to different people, but it makes me feel proud that I've done it and excited to share it with others." And those three students alone have summed up why you'll be hearing about it just so much and why we're all smiling. From an academic point of view, it is exactly the recent inspection that summarised our students' achievements best. Inspectors reported high levels of achievement in the early years, where all children exceeded national expectations. They continued in Chapter House, where pupils achieved above those predicted by standardised assessment tests, and consolidated further in King's Magna. All of this bodes so well for the future of our collegiate and the young ones in it. Sport continues to play a strong part in school life, with teams competing across different sports and different ages. Students regularly getting recognition at county and national events alongside our friendly fixtures. Our four in a row celebration meals have been held regularly throughout the year for different age groups across different sports. It might surprise you that of all the teams that I have accompanied, it is the under 13 girls football team who have won the gold for making the most of the budget, getting as much food as they can, and having not an inch left on the table. Excuse me. Investing in our campus and our students is something we feel is incredibly important. It continues at a strong pace. Our estates department have done a beautiful job of our new boarding house, which is now occupied and complete. The team have worked hard to make it home from home, and I think it's safe to say they've done a really good job. The team have moved eagerly onto a full refurbishment of Abbey Chambers boarding house, which will be completed in stages throughout the year. A new pastoral area for all the students was opened at the start of the year, and absolutely it's been made their own. It's fantastic to see the level of support and care for our entire QE community come from this space. The team are superb. Our ground storage sheds have been completed along with the atrium kitchen. This year has also seen us invest in school vehicles, which service both day and boarding students. Gone are the green Delicas, and we are now replaced with a full fleet of brand new minibuses and cars. I've attended many events in school across the year, and it never ceases to amaze me just how amazing our students are. They're considerate, supportive of each other, resilient, full of character and confidence too. At Chapter House Music and Drama this year, I heard Imogen in Year 3 sing a song from the musical Matilda. It included the line, "Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you." I'm sure it's easier to sing than say. But that night, I actually sat and thought about how our younger students of the collegiate echo these sentiments exactly. They don't let being the younger ones stop them. Their high achievement and determination is set by themselves and supported by staff. Our students support in each other in moments of triumph. Their plight, they have fun. One of my highlights this year was getting involved in the Year 6 Young Enterprise Initiative. This year, students convinced me to double my investment from previous years and assured me that it would be worth doing so. At the sales event, I was approached by Sebastian in his three-piece suit, who promptly asked me if I wished to pay the premium price for a VIP front row seat at the dance competition. Of course, who wouldn't? I was sold. I stood tall, I walked over, I paid my money, and realized there was just one row of seats. This year, the students managed to raise in excess of £600 from £80 investment in 70 minutes of selling, all for charity. Tenacity, quick thinking, and the art of commerce means our Year 6 will go far. In recent weeks, a number of Year 7 personal development classes have been to visit my office and see my two dogs and talk about how dogs can be therapeutic. I'm not sure that they found our giant, one-year-old, not-so-puppy-like Bernese Mountain Dog therapeutic, but he was certainly the centre of attention. The group sat round the meeting table and decided themselves that they would put the setting and the table to good use. And they started a debate about Brexit, as you do in Year 7. Promptly followed up with questions about our campus, what we're building, and the same old, what was the uniform like when you were here, miss? Our students are unique throughout all of our schools, and I am so incredibly proud of all of you. Chapter House and King's Magnus students make the most of the feedback opportunities that we offer. They're not afraid to question something, and they are fantastic at putting their ideas and suggestions forward. Confidence, character, you've all got it in spades. And with traits like this in our students, and alongside staff who are determined to always develop the best provision, we have the winning combination. I am incredibly excited for next year already. But today we reflect on the success of this year. So I would like to wish the very best of luck to our Year 5 and Year 9 students as they move into their next chapters and their new jumpers. And I wish all of our students a very happy and fun-filled summer holiday. Finally, I would like to thank you, the parents, the grandparents, and the guardians who make personal sacrifices for your children to attend QE. I know you have a choice, and we are honoured that you choose us. I can ensure that we are 100% committed to delivering the very best for you and your children. Finally, if any of the Year 6s approach you to sell you the VIP premium picnic lunch, don't listen to them. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Myling Class, Ms. Martin, honoured guests, parents, staff, and most importantly, the pupils of Chapter House and King's Magna. It has been an extremely busy and exciting academic year for Chapter House and King's Magna, with staff working to increase the pupils' independence and enthusiasm for learning at every opportunity. Following on from Chapter House being awarded the primary quality marks for science, literacy and numeracy in the last academic year, this year we were proud to be shortlisted for Prep School of the Year. We were even more delighted with the result of the Independent Schools Inspectorate inspection in February. The glowing early years report judged us to be outstanding in all areas, the highest rating an early years setting can be given by the ISI. They stated that we have created a secure and happy environment which enables children to be highly successful learners. Children are confident to take risks and seek new challenges. I would personally like to thank Ms. Martin and the estates team for trusting in our ideas for the renovations last year, and Mrs. Schofield and the EYFS team for their hard work on a day-to-day basis. The college, from year one upwards, was judged as excellent in all areas too. Again, this is the highest rating given by ISI. It was lovely to see so many quotes about the pupils in Chapter House and King's Magna, and we were so proud of them during this week as they came across to the inspectors as the confident, inquisitive and motivated pupils that they are. Academically, they stated, our pupils' spelling and grammar are particularly strong, and they were seen to write with enthusiasm and higher levels of ability. They applied their mathematical skills well in different areas of learning, with examples seen in the Year 8 three-dimensional design and technology work. In ICT, pupils in Year 2 were observed giving a highly accomplished verbal presentation, speaking with confidence and engaging peers. And in Year 6, the students demonstrated very competent use of coding in their ICT lessons. In personal development, the inspector said that pupils have excellent social and moral awareness, with the youngest pupils displaying virtues of kindness, honesty, and excellent behaviour in every aspect of school life. Mr. Turner and I would like to take this opportunity to thank the pupils and staff for their hard work, not only during this week, but also throughout the year. Children's enthusiasm for and knowledge of topics is increased through the many educational visits and visitors. Miss Blacker led a relaxing yoga session with foundation stage themed around the hungry caterpillar, showing that we have some incredibly flexible children. Last week, the children in foundation stage and key stage one had a wonderful adventure at the Hesketh Farm Park, where they learned how to feed some lambs and went on an exciting tractor ride. In year one, there have been visits to the Yorkshire Arboretum at Castle Howard for outdoor maths and traditional tales, and in March, two science-based trips to Nuzlets, a local animal charity, to learn about the needs of animals and look at different plants and trees. During the autumn term, year two had the pleasure of a private tour around Ripley Castle, linking their castle topic to a local study. In the summer term, as part of the Global Gardens topic, the children visited Harlow Carr, where they investigated the grounds, identifying plants and trees, before observationally drawing the landscape in the style of Vincent van Gogh. To gain knowledge and experience of being an archaeologist, Year 3 visited the Dig in York. During the same trip, the children explored York through the ages while visiting the Minster. In the spring term, the children thoroughly enjoyed an informative workshop titled Fit for a King at Barley Hall, where they experienced life in Tudor times. Year 4 visited the Yorkshire Arboretum, where they learnt about seed dispersal and life cycle of an oak tree. In the spring term, the visit to York Chocolate Story taught the children about the history of chocolate. The final visit of the year to Carlton Lodge Outdoor Adventure Centre developed their team building skills and gave them the opportunity to challenge themselves. Year 5 sampled life as a Saxon for the day at Merton Park and explored their artistic styles by visiting York Art Gallery, taking the time to appreciate a range of artistic styles and producing pieces inspired by what they saw. The much anticipated 3-day residential at High Adventure challenged the children to try new outdoor activities. For many, it was an opportunity for them to be more independent, and by the end of the residential, their confidence shone. The year group were incredibly brave and surpassed their fears. It has been fantastic to see so many Chapter House children involved in weekend enrichment activities this year. In November, Key Stage 2 visited some of London's main attractions, including Buckingham Palace and the West End production of Matilda. In December, children from both Key Stages had a magical train ride where they received a present from Santa. And for the first time, our children were able to be part of the collegiate ski trip to Apreaker, which was a wonderful experience for all children involved. Careers talks have been introduced for all Chapter House children this year, with visitors talking to the children about their jobs and how their careers developed after leaving school. Just a few of the visits included Mr. Hill visiting Foundation Stage to tell them about being a pilot, which the children found very exciting. Key Stage 1 and 2 had the pleasure of being visited by the Bupa Dental Team, where they learned about the importance of cleaning teeth and the impact of a healthy diet on oral hygiene. Year 4 visitors included a talk from Mrs. Gibbons about her career as a lawyer, and Mr. Jandrell speaking about his life as a principal. Year 5 heard from Mrs. Ward, the Director of Banking at Marks & Spencer's, and Mrs. Reynard, who is Managing Director of a marketing company. Through raising money for their house charities, the children learn how to be more responsible and caring towards others. Chapter House charity events have included collections at concerts, cake sales, and non-uniform days, as well as the Red Nose Day activities. Race for Life in the summer term raised nearly £1,800 for Cancer Research UK and saw staff and children running up to 5 kilometres. A staggering total of nearly £3,500 has been raised for charities by Chapter House children this year. It is not only in school that children are raising money. A special mention must go to Freya Thackeray in year 2, for completing a sponsored run and raising £900 for Racing Welfare. Well done, Freya. This year, Chapter House have had sports teams representing 9 different sports, with every child in years 3 to 5, along with several children from year 2 this year, representing Chapter House in a fixture this year. In all sports, there have been numerous outstanding performances and results. The Year 3 girls competed in the Northern ISA dance competition, performing a routine themed around bullying. The Year 4 boys put in a fantastic performance at the ISA Northern football tournament, coming second. For the first time, Chapter House students participated in the Collegiate's Gym and Dance Show, with the Year 5 students having the opportunity to perform a cheerleading routine with KM and QE students. Following on from their performances in this event, several Chapter House students have been selected to join the Collegiate's Elite Gymnastics Club. Last week, children competed in the ISA Athletics competition, representing the school well, both through their efforts and their behaviour on the day. Individual successes this year include Sophie Limbu, who finished 5th in floor and vault at the British Schools Gymnastics Association competition. Giovanni Inipa won the 60-metre race, and Molly Place won the long jump at the ISA Athletics competition, which led her to representing the North of England in the ISA national competition this week. I would like to invite Sophie, Molly and Giovanni to the stage to receive a certificate in recognition of their fantastic achievements in school sports this year. Lovely to see the children involved in so many extracurricular activities, both in and out of school. In school, the quiz team reached the semi-finals of the Key Stage 2 General Knowledge Championships, and the Year 4s reached the final of the Fly to the Line glider competition. Out of school, Hermione Gibbons in year four enjoyed a busy panto season, performing as part of the chorus in Beauty and the Beast at the Carriage Works Theatre in Leeds. And Bastian Fuentes in year two was shortlisted for ISA Artist of the Month, and last week was in London filming an advert for M&S. We do love hearing about the wide range of things the children get up to at home, but I think Oz Place has had the most unique experience. He now has his own lambing business, producing three lambs this season, two males, which will go for sale at market, and a female, which will be used for future breeding programmes. Well done, Oz. It has been the second year of running the Chats House My School Experience, and all children have embraced the challenge to fully involve themselves in the life of Chapter House. Challenges including having a role of responsibility in school, representing their house in an event, and fully attending a creative or sporting club. I would now like to invite the Gold Award winners to the stage to receive their certificates. Well done, Pazelle, Sophia, and Cole. Creative Arts Department continued the Widening Opportunities Initiative, with all children in years 2 to 5 learning instruments in music this year, including the violin, clarinet, and ukulele. Year 5 took part in the Young Voices concert at Sheffield Arena, with thousands of other school children. They sang beautifully and performed some great dance moves too. The Key Stage 2 choir enjoyed their carol singing at the nursing home again this Christmas, and performed in the QE Choir Festival, alongside the other collegiate choirs. We were very proud of how confidently the children presented themselves at this occasion. They looked and sounded very professional. I would now like to invite pupils from years 3 to 9 to the stage to give a taste of some of the fantastic singing talent in Chapter House and King's Magna, singing May Rainbow Run Beside You. Thank you.
It's also been a very busy and exciting year in King's Magna. We've focused our attentions on high academic expectations and providing a consistent, engaging and challenging experience for all of our learners. In English, we've challenged our students to take part in a host of competitions, with the increasingly popular Poetry by Heart taking place earlier this week, which was won by Cantuara. Our creative writing competition in the autumn term was won by Sophia Matheson with her piece entitled Watching. And in recognition of the changing way in which we communicate, we've introduced two new competitions this year. Kirsten Walsh won the Microfiction Award and Sophia Hill the Twitterature Award for the best piece of writing of 140 characters or less. In humanities, Year 7 geographers created T-shirt designs to explain the differences and connections between different parts of geography. It turned out to be a very fiercely fought competition, which was won by Imogen Horseman. Meanwhile, in history, Emir Ozan won the castle building competition, and Aoife Blake the pyramid building competition. Outside the classroom, the curriculum was supported with visits to Eden Camp, Tropical World, the Royal Armouries, Robin Hood's Bay, Malham and York. And Year 9 history students learnt first-hand experiences of the Holocaust from a visit from a survivor. Science, technology, engineering and mathematics play a pivotal role in our curriculum. And this year, our ever-popular Science Week was really captured the imagination of our students with its theme of sustainability. Meanwhile, in the Institute of Physics Olympics in York, our team of Georgia Moyo, Timofey Shestopolov, Ellis Bailey, and Bridget Garung won first place in events called The Long and Short of It. This year also saw two new competitions being entered, run by the RAF: Fly to the Line and Race to the Line. The model gliders made by our Year 6s were good enough to get through to the regional heats and into the national finals at RAF Cosford. Meanwhile, the explosive charges which propelled the aerodynamic racing cars produced by the Year 7s were good enough also to qualify for the national finals. We continue to be a centre of excellence in mathematics, and a total of 39 pupils achieved commendations in the National Mathematics Challenges. Our best in school were the Gold Award-winning Mangsam Senahang and Jasmine Turton, and they qualified for the next round of the competition, which took part last week. Once again, students in Years 8 and 9 achieved outstanding results in the Oxford University Computational Challenge, with Rhys Perry winning the coveted Best in School Award, and Suash Ray came a close second place. In February, we took the whole of our Year 8 to the National Media Museum for a computing roadshow, and subsequently entered 12 applications for the BAFTA Young Game Designers Award, with notable contributions from Timofey Shestopolov and Oliver Swindles, who produced outstanding concepts and project management. The highlight of the year for Modern Foreign Languages was the eagerly anticipated Eurofest challenge in May. Pupils in Year 8 pitched business ideas in French, German or Spanish to visitors to their exhibitions, using creative approaches to marketing their products in their chosen language. There have been plenty more opportunities for pupils to practice their entrepreneurial skills this year, with Year 7 students working with sixth form business students on an upcycle event. And as you heard earlier, all our Year 6s took part in a young enterprise project with business mentors HSBC Corporate Banking. The final selling day took place with over £650 being raised. The winning team, Multifun, grew a £10 investment into a profit of £227. And the Best Business Manager Award went to Lara Haig. In creative arts, the academic year began with great excitement, with news that our school production this year would be Beauty and the Beast. And just over a week ago, we hosted our very own King's Magna production of Alice. It featured 44 performers from King's Magna, with Erin Kelly producing an outstanding performance in the lead role as audiences were treated to a truly professional show. It's no surprise then that 8 students obtained merits or distinctions in Lambda examinations this year. Our annual house music competition is now firmly established in the calendar, and this year's winning performance was a piano piece by the hugely talented Priscilla Ho, who you heard at the start of today's ceremony. The highlight of the year for many of our students is the annual gym and dance display, which this year celebrated its 10th anniversary. It was bigger and better than ever. Sold out on 3 evenings, 29 acts and over 100 King's Magna pupils from years 6 to 9 took part. And many of the performers were lucky enough to work with Strictly Come Dancing's Amy Dowden on the Saturday afternoon to choreograph a routine for the final show. And we've had another outstanding year in sport. It seems like a really long time ago since we won the ISA North of England Swimming Gala, and following which Maria Rozanova, Georgia Mayo Ella Rowden and Robert Rowden were all selected to represent the North of England team in the national finals at the Olympic Park in London. Also down at the Olympic Park in London this year were our under 11 and under 13 boys and girls hockey teams for the ISI national finals. The under 13 girls won the plate competition while the under 13 boys came 3rd overall and then became quarter finalists in the National Independent Schools Cup later in the year. We were also delighted that the under 11 girls came 3rd in the ISA North of England Rounders competition, and a fabulous performance from the under 11 boys rugby team won the bowl at the Audenshaw Sevens. Our under 11 boys were runners up at the ISA North of England football competition before coming 4th in the ISA national finals at St George's Park. And it's the turn of the under 13 girls to go down to the National Football Centre as ISA North of England champions next week to compete in the national finals, and we wish you the best of luck in that. The under 13 girls also made it through to the ISA nationals for netball, and it was the very first time we'd achieved that level, and they came 4th overall in that competition. It's no surprise then that Ruthie Nakawawa, Georgia Moyo, Sophia Hill and Mary Dresser have all represented North Yorkshire at netball this year. And the under 13 girls can also turn their hands around us, and they recently came 3rd nationally in the England Independent Schools Tournament. So, with national success in hockey, in rounders, in netball and in football, without a shadow of doubt, our under 13 girls are the most successful team we have ever had in King's Magna. On behalf of everyone who has represented under 13s this year, I would like to invite team captains Tegan Bell, Rio Goodings, Meeman Thapper, Sophia Hill and Georgia Moyo onto stage to collect their award for outstanding contributions to sport. In athletics, Kajon Ferguson, Kian Winter and Sophia Hill all represented the ISA North of England in the National Cross Country Finals. And the summer season has seen the Year 6 girls, the Year 7, 8 and 9 boys as ISA North of England champions. A total of 18 athletes were selected to represent the North of England at the National Finals at the Alexander Stadium this week. We won 14 medals, including 5 gold medals, 2 of which were won by Keziah Barr, and 1 each for Bryce Farmer-Beasley, Orelua Oladell, and Michael Azaka. These are truly outstanding achievements. Can we give them a big round of applause, please? Other significant individual achievements in sport have included Georgia Moyo and Anna Edbury at the Northern School of Contemporary Dance, Josh Tynan, who has been selected to play cricket for Yorkshire, Roman Lofthouse, who has represented the North East at hockey, as well as equestrian success for Ellis Jones and Sebastian Gray, pigeon shooting for Lily Horn, and karate from Ethan Henry. And as we continue to develop our performance sports programme next year, we look forward to yet more success in the future. Our co-curricular enrichment programme extends well beyond sport and creative arts. We have over 100 weekly activities offered to pupils in King's Magna. In Year 6, we've continued to develop the Enrichment Awards scheme that rewards participation in a broad range of activities during the year. Our enrichment leadership team have reviewed all this year's portfolios, and from the 11 gold award winners, we would like to welcome overall winner Tiana Barnwell, together with Ruby Wilkinson and Samisha Ray, on stage to collect their certificates for outstanding commitment to co-curricular achievements. The co-curricular team have also organised our widest range of trips and visits this year, highlights being the poignant remembrance trip to London, the CCF overseas exercise to Gibraltar, ski trip to Italy, volunteering trip to complete conservation work in Thailand, and our annual diving residential to Malta. Students from Year 7 to 9 will embark on the trip of a lifetime tomorrow to Zambia, where they will contribute to the renovation of a rural school. As part of our outreach enrichment programme, we've planted crocus bulbs to raise awareness for polio, and our front of house students have served afternoon tea to guests from a local Contact the Elderly group. And all in total, we've supported over 20 charities this year, including in June when we took part in the Race for Life as part of Cancer Awareness Week, raising over £3,000. The most remarkable achievement of that day going to Lily Horn, who completed the entire 5 kilometres on a pair of crutches. Indeed, we've raised over £20,000 this year for charity, and I would like to congratulate all our pupils for their hard work and that of the charity committee. That is truly tremendous. We pride ourselves on our pastoral care, and our pastoral team this year moved into new accommodation in Bronte House in January. Since then, that's enabled us to put on over 30 Thrive sessions each week, and it's also enabled us to invest in our anti-bullying ambassadors, who in February received a whole day of training in York. We now have 138 King's Magna students who work as buddies within pastoral, supporting either Chapter House students or their peers. And it's thanks to the dedication and enthusiasm of the staff in Chapter House and King's Magna that the students become such independent and confident learners. We must also thank you, the parents, for your support in attending events within our school. From the Advent Carol service and concerts to supporting children at the many sporting events, these events would not be so successful without your unending support. Finally, we come to the most important people within Chapter House and King's Magna, our students. Their efforts this year in all areas have made their teachers so proud. They continually amaze with their enthusiasm and the way in which they live up to the school motto, to be the best that they can with the gifts that they have. Well done to you all on such a successful year. Good luck to Year 5 and Year 9 as you move through to King's Magna, College and Faculty in September.
Dear honoured guests, parents and students, I started in Chapter House as a Year 3 student. In that time, I have had some amazing experiences. At High Adventure, stepping out of my comfort zone was challenging. But this only came apparent as I tried abseiling from an enormous 8-foot wall. The trip was a great learning experience for me and my peers, as we were faced with challenges that we had not come across before. It shows that it does not matter how difficult things can be, but if we persevere, we will always be rewarded with success. Rugby, football, cricket, and athletics are just a few sports that I have represented our school in. I think we are grateful for the PE staff to taking the time and effort in training us to be competitive, confident, and most of all, enjoy whatever sport we take part in. Chapter House will always provide us with great leaders now and in years to come. I am proud that I can move on knowing that I have achieved the essential skills and knowledge that would aid me later in my journey. I'm confident and content that me and my peers will be able to take on the challenges that await us in King's Magna. Molly has been at Chapter House quite a bit longer than me, so I'm going to leave it to her to explain why Chapter House is so special.
I have been lucky enough to be a student at Chapter House my whole school life. During that time, I have seen lots of big changes. The sports fields were dug up and new ones were built. We were given a whole new playground, our classrooms were refurbished, and they even built muggles. I've also had the opportunity to have some amazing experiences. I've leapt into a freezing lake at High Adventure, I've travelled back in time at York Railway Museum, and I've even caught a fish and took it home for my dinner. But it's not the big things I want to talk about today. It's the small things, the things that we take for granted each day. All schools have classrooms, teachers, and lessons. All schools have PE, sports teams, and competitions. All schools have music, art, and drama productions. So what is it that makes Chapter House so special? I believe it is the small things. I can remember when I was in nursery, one day I was feeling sad. A prefect noticed. She came over to me and played with me. She made me feel better. I have tried to be like her as I've moved through the school, especially in my year as being the role of head girl. I still see her around. If I see someone being left out, I try to get them involved. Looking back on that day in nursery, I can see that what that prefect showed me was what makes Chapter House special. We look after each other. We take care of each other. We all have a common goal to be the best that we can with the gifts that we have, and we work together to ensure that all of us fulfill this goal. It is true that our school is different. For a start, we get to work together with students of all ages. This year, me and my friends were part of the Collegiate's Gym and Dance Show, where we performed for our parents and guests over 3 nights. The opportunity to be part of a show working with students of all ages was an amazing experience and a brilliant opportunity for us to learn from them, not to mention the strictly professionals. Without us really noticing, the thing that makes our school special happens every day, whether it's a little extra help when we can't solve a maths question, or a little extra recognition when we perform a piece of music without dropping a note. It's these little extras that help us to make this place special. I know that all of us in Year 5 have changed a lot since we started our school journeys. Just like Sam, we are more confident, we have more knowledge and skills, we have developed a growth mindset that allows us to overcome any challenge that is placed in front of us. We have more friends and have learnt to work better as a team. Most importantly, we have learnt how to apply these new skills and knowledge. But changes did not just happen overnight. They happened over time. They are the result in lots of small changes and small lessons that have happened along the way. We are the next generation. We will inherit the world that the adults leave us. In our lesson, we have learned about our planet, about recycling, and about pollution. We can see that in the news, our planet is facing some big changes. But as I've talked about, little changes can make one big difference. So I challenge all of you here today to make one difference. be it turning off the tap while you clean your teeth or taking your rubbish home and putting it in your recycling. If we all make a change, together we can make a big difference. Before we finish, on behalf of all my fellow students in Year 5, we would like to say a big thank you to everyone who has helped us grow and who makes Chapter House so special. We would like to say thank you to Ms. Kilkenny and all the teaching staff who have made the estate run so smoothly.
We would like to say thank you to the boarding staff for supporting us and making our time in house such good fun. To all our peers we are leaving behind, we urge you to enjoy your time, cherish the unforgettable moments and friendship that you will build along the way, and most of all, enjoy what Chapter House has to offer. We wish the new head boy and head girl a successful year ahead, and would like to wish everyone in Year 4 the best of luck in Year 5. We hope you all have as much fun as we did.
Finally, we would like to say to our friends in Year 5 as we transition into King's Magna, let's smash it!
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, staff, proud parents, and students of King's Magdalen Chapter House. I feel very honored to be standing here in front of you today for the second time. 4 years have passed since I was a student in Chapter House, and I thought that 4 years later, it would be less nerve-wracking. But I have to admit, it is just as bad, if not worse. Nevertheless, here I am, and what a great opportunity it is to be standing in front of you today. The first thing that I'd like to say is thank you. Thank you to all the staff and students in King's Magna that have made my journey as head girl an enjoyable and very manageable one. As many of you might know, my school career didn't start in King's Magna, and I would like to thank Ms. Kilkenny for providing me with a strong foundation and smooth pathway into King's Magna. Mr. Turner and Ms. Farity, your support and guidance in King's Magna have been invaluable. I sincerely appreciate the opportunities that I have been given, and I would not have been able to do it without the support of Toby and the prefect team. I have racked my brain and heart for what I ought to say to you today. I have asked myself what I wish I would like to have known and the kind of advice I would like to receive upon making the next step in my school career. I have come up with one answer. On this wonderful last day of the term, when we're here to celebrate all of our achievements, I have decided to talk to you about my journey and some of the challenges that I have faced throughout my short school career. From the age of 2.5 to when I was 7 years old, I faced many difficulties with my hearing. It was a challenge being accepted into a mainstream school in South Africa, and my parents had tried to send me to a private school, but the school thought I would not cope academically in a normal environment. I can honestly say now that I'm grateful that they did not accept me. Otherwise, I would not be here today. Eventually, I went to another school, which accepted me with open arms, like Queen Elizabeth did when I arrived in England. We all face challenges in life, yet with the right attitude, patience, and support, many of these challenges can be overcome. I always prove myself by going the extra mile with hard work and effort. My mom had always assured me that I would overcome many of the difficulties that I experienced. So, Mom, thank you for all your hard work in making a huge difference in my life and showing me that courage is not something that you already have that makes you brave when the tough times start. Courage is what you've earned when you've been through the tough times and you discover they aren't so tough after all. My experience in King's Magna has been very rewarding. I've had the opportunity to learn new skills in a fun environment and failed a number of times along the way. We have to accept that friendships will be made and lost. We won't always gain the grades that we expect, and that failure and mistakes are part of our learning experience. My dad rarely asks me how well I do at something and how good my grades are. He is always more interested in knowing what mistakes I have made during the week and what I have failed at. His reaction is always the same when I tell him. He says, "Mistakes are fascinating. Dad, those words have always stayed with me since I was small and made me realize the importance of accepting failure and being open about it." I would like to leave today by providing a few words of advice for the students in King's Magna and Chapter House. We all have dreams. Let's all try and fulfill our dreams. Be consistent every single day and never give up. Don't worry about what other people think. I know this is a tough one, but that is something we have to deal with every single day. Finally, don't live with the fact that you could have accomplished great achievements at school. We can all make our dreams come true with passion and fun. Don't wait for that someday moment. I wish you all a wonderful summer, and I look forward to seeing all of you in the new academic year. Thank you.
Good morning, honoured guests, parents, students and staff. I'm now delighted to welcome an inspirational woman, Mylene Klass, a British singer, a pianist of the highest standard, and also a businesswoman, fashion designer and model. Mylene Klass was a part of the famous pop group Hearsay. They released 2 albums and 4 singles, 2 of them achieving number 1 in the UK. Ms. Klass released 2 solo classical albums in 2003 and in 2007. In recent years, she has worked more as a television and radio presenter. She has hosted a range of shows such as Pop Star to Opera Star and The One Show, also making frequent appearances on the lunchtime chat Loose Women. She also showed great courage in the all-famous I'm Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, and finished in a superb 2nd place. Ms. Klass has done a great deal of charity work. She visited Sierra Leone to help villagers build up their lives and environment surrounding them. She has worked a lot more with charity campaigns, such as Childline. Without further ado, please give a warm welcome to Mylene Klass.
Hello and good afternoon. Thank you so much for having me here today. It is a massive, massive privilege. Thank you, Miss Amy. Thank you to the staff for making me feel so welcome, to the children that I've met and some of the parents. It's something I really, really wanted to do today, actually. So much so that you mentioned I'm a radio presenter. If you turn on to Smooth, I'm actually on the radio right now. But please don't tell anybody that I'm actually here. And actually, I'm also on Classic FM tonight. That's probably when I'll be on the train on the way home. I did not want to miss today. That's what I'm trying to say to you. It's such an important day today. I have 2 children myself, 1 on the way, a few weeks to go. You'll be glad to hear. Thank you. But for me, education is absolutely everything. It really is. On my dad's side, he's from Austria, he was a Navy engineer, a Navy diver. On my mum's side, she's from the Philippines, she worked as a nurse. I did not get born into a family that could maybe necessarily give me the amazing opportunities that I see before me. But what I did do is make the best of what I had. I trained as a classical pianist at the Royal Academy of Music. I absolutely loved music. In my mind, I was going to go on and join an orchestra, or I was going to be a conductor. It had to be music orientated. Now, when I hear that list that your wonderful head boy just read out there, I never would have dreamed in a million years to have had the opportunities that I've had. A few weeks ago, my job was to play the piano with my daughters for Prince Charles. We were terrified, all of us, but I still pinched myself thinking, is this my job for today? My job last week was to interview Miley Cyrus. My kids thought that was the best job ever. My job is to fly to crisis zones like the Philippines to help when there's been a typhoon, to go to places like Sierra Leone that was mentioned, the DEC, the Congo, to fly to places that some people have never been to help as an NGO, to help to save the children. Things that, again, as a musician, I never imagined I would have the chance to fulfill. I am 5'5". If you read my Wikipedia page, it says 5'6". To be a model, you need to be 5'7", 5'8". And yet, I've bucked the trend again. Because I think if you just try and do different things, if you try and do things that maybe nobody else has tried before you, if you just try and maybe expand on what is necessarily thought of you, again, like I said, people thought I'd just play in an orchestra, you can do absolutely anything. I've got a question for you. Hands up, who knows where Mog Mog is? Oh, 1 hand, 2 hands, 2 hands. None from the teachers, I see. All right, let's broaden it out. Who knows where a place called Ulithi is? Still the same hand up. The Yap Islands? Oh, teachers. Micronesia? Yes, more, Micronesia. Okay, a few more hands. So I was offered a job. Would I like to fly out and work with a tribe in Mog Mog? I'd never heard of Mog Mog. It's in Ulithi. Never heard of Ulithi. The Yap Islands. Can somebody get me a map, and quickly? Incidentally, my dad knew, which is reassuring because, as I said, he was in the Navy. It turns out I had to fly with a grand piano to Japan, to Nagasaki, take my piano, and then take it in pieces, by the way, in a light aircraft. It was a very squished light aircraft. And I had to fly with my piano in pieces and build it on an island in Ulithi, and then get on a boat, take my piano across to a tribe that lived on the island of Mog Mog. I wasn't allowed to stand up, because if you stand up on the boat, other than you could potentially fall out of the boat, it meant that you were coming to attack. So I was like a little ball trying to hide underneath my piano. When I arrived on the island, we were greeted by a tribe of maybe 70 or 80 people who don't really see people from the Western world. And my job was to live with them for a week and write a song. Now, it was one of the most magical experiences of my life. Again, nobody prepared me when I was at the academy. Nobody prepared me that this was a job that I would be able to do. But I got to live on the island, write music with my piano. By the way, I left my piano on the island because there was no way I was going to get back on that boat and that like aircraft and fly my piano all the way back from Nagasaki back to England. But what was so wonderful is we didn't speak the same language. We didn't sing the same songs. I didn't even know that if I performed, if they'd even clap at the end. I didn't know if that's a universal language. But what was so wonderful was to be in the company of people that I'd never met, but we could all speak the same language, which was music, and which was friendship, and which was just coming together. Now, the opportunities that get afforded to me are things that I never imagined. I have jumped out of helicopters. My mum was terrified. She will never let me do it again. I have jumped out of helicopters on programs like The Jungle. I have played with my idols, Gary Barlow on the piano, Prince Charles as a performer. I've got the chance to model and to interview people that, again, I grew up wanting just even just be in the same room and be inspired by. But something that I always share with my own children, which I'd like to share with you today, is none of those opportunities were given to me. I went out and I found them myself. And that's what you're going to have to do. That you might think I'm on the path to be a scientist and that's it. But what happens if maybe the job is taken or the job doesn't exist later on? You might have to find different avenues. Or there might be other things you might want to do as a scientist and elaborate, diversify on that idea. The same goes for being a mathematician. The same thing goes for being a linguist. But the one thing that does remain is work hard. And I know you do all work so hard. I mean, your reputation as this school speaks for itself. But work hard. Don't be afraid to diversify. And always, always be nice to the person that makes the tea. I'm going to tell you a story. A few weeks ago, there was a girl that was given work experience at Global, which is where I do one of my many jobs at Classic FM. And her job was to make the tea. I mean, everyone loves a good cup of tea. And she turned around and she said, my dad did not send me here on work experience to make the tea. And I was really, really shocked when I heard this and really saddened, because when I was working at CNN, there was a boy, his name was Marcus. He'd flown over from Germany. He spoke four languages and his job was an intern, so he wasn't necessarily paid very much, if at all, but his job was to make the tea. He played the piano, he wrote the scripts, he filmed the scenes, he carried the bags, he worked his way up. 6 months later, Marcus was my producer. And what I want you to take from that is no job is too big for any of us. And also, you never know when your next opportunity or where your next opportunity is going to come from. My very first job was cleaning pianos in my local music shop. And now I get to play any piano around the world on an island in Mog Mog, say. So I think what I'd like to say as my lasting words to all of you is congratulations. Congratulations with all the hard work that you've put in. Huge congratulations to the parents, because it's not easy, the amount of encouragement, the amount of support you give, that isn't necessarily always noticed by your children, but it will be. And ultimately, remember, diversify, work hard, and find that passion. Find that passion, because when you find a job you love, it will never, ever feel like a job, ever. And for me, thank you so much for making me feel so welcome and having me here today. I actually want to move my children from the school. I think I want to move all of us just to York to attend this school, because it is just so wonderful. Work hard. Thank you so much.
These are the prizes for the academic year 2018 to 2019. The year prizes. For year one, it's Isabella Costello. Year two, Freya Thackeray. Year three, Aoife Mitchell. Year four, Hermione Gibbons. Year five, William Kelly.
In year six, Charles Berger. In year seven, Mark Jandrell. In year eight, Rubina Rana Moga. And in year nine, Adele Cullimore.
And for the progress prizes, year one, Alicia Jones. Year three, Lola Day. Year four, Ryan Boxwell. And year five, Monty Collins.
In year six, Pip Morris. Year seven, Evie Butterfield. In year eight, Georgia Moyo. And in year nine, Megan Henry Crossland.
And for the subject prizes, for art, Bazel Sabakwe.
And Beth Wang.
For computing, Zach Archibald.
And Rhys Perry.
For design technology, Dasha Asante
and Ryan Wilshire.
For drama, Amelia Walker
and Anna Mae Edbury.
For English, Ina Jeffrey
and Millie Tynan.
Geography, Archie Butterworth
and Luke Gordon.
History, Maisie Rintoul Kidman
and Millicent Lofthouse.
For mathematics, Liam Boxwell
and Samantha Smith.
For modern foreign languages, Sophia Sowersby
and Joe Barry.
For music, Molly Place
and Eden Cusack.
Science, Oisin Mitchell
and Hannah McQuare.
The Boys Sports Awards go to William Sykes
and Angus Chan.
And for girls' sport, Sophie Limbu
and Emily Hartreth Shute.
Head Girls Prize go to Molly Place
and Giovanna Zarabini.
The Head Boys Prizes go to Samuel Gether
and Toby Harrison.
For commitment to extracurricular, Sophia Sowersby
and Hannah Wardman.
The Hill Standard goes to Sophie Limbu
and Ekaterina Nikotina. And the winner this year of the Todd Crooks Memorial Prize is LaSasha Barnwell.
And finally, for the eagerly awaited award where working as a team reaps its rewards, this year, the cup for the most house points in Chapter House goes to Darwent.
And in King's Magna, the winner of the House Cup is Cantuara.
Concludes the academic prizes for this year.
Thank you, and please join me in congratulating all of our worthy winners.
On behalf of everyone here at Chapter House in King's Magna, we would like to say a big thank you to Miss Mylene Class for taking the time to be with us today. You have informed, entertained, and inspired us all.
A special thanks to the staff for their support and guidance throughout the year, and to the Chapter House and King's Magna students who have achieved so much this year. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our Speech Day proceedings for 2019. Just a reminder that Chapter House students will be now escorted back to school by their teachers and can be collected from the front entrance of Chapter House. King's Magna students will meet you at the marquee, where you are invited to join us for a delightful picnic lunch. I'd like to invite our dignified guests and parents to now leave the auditorium, followed by students who will be directed by their form tutors. Can I request that all prize winners remain behind and you will be escorted by members of staff to the library for photographs. I do hope you have a lovely afternoon, a fabulous evening, and a memorable start to the holidays. Thank you.